So welcome to my first solo primitive camp out in the woods. The first part of the video, I forgot to put on my microphone. So here I am just going through my kit. I've got reindeer fur. This is two reindeer skins put together, which will be my blanket. A bag here with my possibles kit in, which carries all my little bits. I have in my bag my other kit, which is blankets, bow drill kit, moccasins there, bow with rawhide string, hat to keep my balding head warm at night time, just like a great wig. And then more reindeer furs. This one's part of a ground sheet that I will lie on. Got a couple of those. And then bow drill kits. I have some limpet shells here, which are really good for the bearing block. So I have a clay pot here that I use to cook in and boil water. I've got more rawhide string and cord there, a spare piece of string as well, that's a thong, and more reindeer furs to keep me nice and warm at night time. And now I'm just sped up the film a little bit because this took about an hour to build, and I'm just setting up underneath this cedar sapling that's fallen down. I'm going to make a little lean-to, quick lean-to, with all the materials around me. Okay, so this is where I'm walking over to this little, water feature here. And I'm just, what I'm doing is making my rawhide bow for my bow drill kit just damp so it doesn't snap when I use it. Because it is an organic material, you need to look after it every now and then. Sometimes I'll put a little bit of animal fat on it, but tend just to use water. It seems to work the best, and it seems to last longer in that way, because when I put animal fats on it, you can smell a bit and get a bit rancid. So that's what I'm doing here, which is putting in the water, rinsing it off, and stretching it at the same time. So just getting back into my camp now, I'm just going to test the bow drill with the spindle in it, just to make sure it doesn't slip and make sure it's just moist enough. And it's got that amount of stretch in it, which it does, which is good. And then I'm going to go through what's in my possibles kit. Now, when I was doing the Stone Age show in Bulgaria, this is the thing we carried around everywhere with us. I've got in there sinew, and I've got a cow knee socket, or it's actually an ankle bone, can't remember the name of it, and that's a spare bearing block. That bearing block's now 10 years old, I've been using that for making fires, seen lots of fires. Here I've got some nettle line with a float, and that float is a gall wasp from an oak tree, gall wasp. That's some horsehair and stinging nettle line there. And other bits, I've got a bone awl right there, made up of a leg bone of a deer. Got some pine resin here, some raw pine resin. This is great for all sorts of applications. If you cut yourself, you can put it over a cut to seal it. Good for scraping into fire. Good for turning it into glue with other materials as well. But yeah, just everything you kind of need to live from the land primitively. Now, just put my bag away, and then coming back over, what I'm going to do now, I've got some cedar bark, and I will start processing that with a little stone tool I've got, just scraping the inside of it, which will form a nice fine fibre for our tinder bundle for fire lighting later on.
So just swapping out batteries on the camera, and I just realised that the mic wasn't turned on. So that whole hour of me there, unfortunately, have no sound to it. So I'll probably just do a voiceover when I put it together in the edit. Where I got up to was scraping a tinder bundle here from some cedar bark, which we used to light a fire with that. And then what I got up to was digging a hole here using my kind of hand digger, hand axe tool. I don't use it for chopping, it's used it for digging holes, and that's for breaking up the roots and then digging at the other end, digging stick. So what I was doing is breaking through this top layer of all the roots in it, which tends to be quite flammable, and then I've dug a hole in the ground here and just brushed it up for my nice little fire pit. So, and then I'm going to get some other pieces of wood to put down in there and get a bow drill fire going. Once I found some more cedar. So what I'm doing now is just going to scrape some cedar bark to get a slightly bigger timber bundle. And this is what I was doing earlier, just before I realised my microphone wasn't switched on. So we'll remedy that in the edit, we'll do something. So what I'm doing now is just scraping the inner bark off this bit of cedar that I peeled off. Off a dead standing bit of tree, so there's not that much moisture in it. And look at that, it's just hair-like and soft and very fibrous, which will help us catch an ember. And you just want to make a tiny little depression to pour your ember in when you get it. The key thing is not to poke a hole through the middle. That's good, I'll keep that there nice and dry. Got a half. So I have an ember catcher as well. Just use this actually. Just looking for a little bit of leather to go over the limpet shelves. I've got a giant limpet there and a small one that I'm going to put inside it, and then that should stop that heat rising up through and burning, because it will get really hot. So earlier I made that nice and damp, that rawhide. Place it in here and we'll see. A little bit more oomph and we'll get there. Probably just drop one of those limpet shells out and then so my notch is filled up, which is good. Right, let's go, let's get this. November. Okay. Almost through on that one. Could I get one out of that bit? Might have to burn in again. Close. Okay. Let's see what I've got on this one. I'll get that one to work. So I'm just going to drill in a little hole in here and then find a way to make a notch in the wood. Just burning in now. That's nice. Now, what I need to do is find a rock. It's like a bit of slab or something, and then you can use the edge of that to cut in a notch. There you go. see that's making just a tiny divot in it, which is good. And a really rough edge. There you go. So it acts as an abrasive. That's working pretty well. Getting closer. That it works better because it's a bit more abrasive. Okay. Now, what I thought I brought with me but didn't is my little flint blades. But it shows you don't need them. Just a bit of more elbow grease, practical thinking, and a paving slab that you find in the woods, and you got yourself a primitive setup right there. Just adapting. That's all our ancestors did, they adapted to the environment. Yeah, that's working really well. That's fine. Another edge. More in the middle there and we'll be good. Blade. I've got that little what I was using before was little arrow point here, stone arrow point. Quite lucky I left it in my bag. What I'm doing now is just cutting away any flecks of or fibres from the wood so the dust when I drill in doesn't get caught in it. Yeah, that looks pretty good on there. Right, let's see if I've got it in me to make fire. Oh, maybe I could use that. That'd be good. Stand on that. That goes on there. That sits there like that. Put it away. Oh, come on, fire. Now, that's all out of the way. Here's my bundle. My bundle of sticks. I'll just give this a little tap. Put that out of the way. You can see. I'll just let that grow a bit. But you can see there. There's a coal. And now, because it's not too windy, I'll just let that grow so it becomes stronger, because this is vital now. Fire, there you go, that's perfect. Carefully tip it in there. Now we just carefully build this up. What I'll do is I'll put some bigger ones just in the middle here, like this, to build up, and then I'll get my dry ones. I've got over there, and what the dry ones will do, this fine stuff will draw up the heat, and as they catch, they'll dry the stuff in the middle quicker. That's the theory anyway. There we go. Nice fire. Right, get everything in order. Let's get this stuff off the ground and away while the fire is burning. That can go in there. That can lean up. I'll get my string. Got a nice fire, and I've got some sweet chestnut flour, and I've got this stump, this bit of stone from the clay pot. We'll mix up and make some sweet chestnut flour cakes. Get that warm in. I can boil some water in there as well. Got my spoon. It's nice, it's nice, and that breeze is coming across my shelter, which is nice, taking that smoke away. See, if I put my back of my shelter here, the wind would come over the top and it would just form an eddy, and then all the smoke would go into my shelter and I'd be coughing all night. But now this is good, like this. Okay, clay pot, vitally important. That'll get the warm there. Got my bag of sweet chestnut flour. That can go there. I don't know how well that's gonna go as a cooking stone. We'll see. I suppose just heat it up really slowly. Oh, that's nice and warm. That should be okay there like that. Deer hair in there. A couple of handfuls of this. Let's go, let's pour it all in. berries, and I didn't see any berries when I walked in. There's nothing, there's no crab apples hanging onto the apple tree over there. I might go and have another look in a minute. That's warming nicely. Sweet chestnut flower is awesome. It's really, really nice stuff. And if you just leave it for a bit, I thought I put too much water in, but I left it for a bit and it will just all bind and absorb. And then we'll turn that, I'll put it on the slab when that's heated up, and then we can put it into cakes. There we go. Yum-tastic. I don't want to heat that up too quick, because I'm a bit unsure of what that rock might do. If it may explode. So we'll just heat it up slowly. And I need a good pokey stick. Ah, that's a good one. It's amazing the difference from being here. This is really warm over here to the other, really warm in here, the other side of the shelter that's really cold where that wind is. That's nice, there you go. Good bed of coals here. So what I can do is arrange my fire. Just a few coals underneath, the main bit of the fire over there, and that. Yeah, that's warming nicely. Got a little bit of flour left, what I can do is just sprinkle it on here, and hopefully the cakes won't stick. What I could have done, I'll do next time in another video, is I'll make you can get the flour and make hazelnut flour, works really well. Put stinging nettle seeds in, which are really good. So, look at that. And we'll just make it into almost a little patty, a little burger. Actually, I haven't got any fat. So we'll just... Oh, that's nice. They'll be almost biscuits in a way, I think. There we go. You can add berries and everything. Cherries, good. Oh, there you go. Classic. Bit of woodland debris on that one, oh well. So while they're cooking, I'll collect some more firewood. Let's have a look at these cakes, biscuits. Slowly, slowly. Oh yeah, that's good. Oh, that's going good. Oops. So good. we can pour some water and I'll go and look for some pine. And have a pine needle tea. So just on my little forage, I've got some brambles, bramble leaf, which is really good, and some pine, bung a couple of sprigs in there, and let that brew. And these cakes are coming along well. That's brewing nicely. I'll put that in, so I'm not going to turn it. I usually turn this, but because I don't have my other cup with me, I'll keep that side out of the fire so it stays cool. Cooler. So a really simple camp, really. This is my first video doing something like this, so I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to do more. I think I've got a cowhide coracle that I might do a river trip on that, and an overnight camp. So that could be coming up in the next video. I hope to do more of these, and I hope with the support of everyone watching that I can. Because it's really just a simple way of doing this completely primitively, which excites me a lot. You know, and it's sort of always when you sit there looking at the fire and you're watching primitive TV, you kind of sort of think back to our ancestors and how simple and hard their lives were. They had to work for everything. But I kind of like that way, you know, of having to source my food and water. It's tough, but the rewards are great. And you're just really reminded of how resilient and awesome our ancestors were. Nowadays, everything seems a bit too easy. We're always in our comfort zone, whereas here, you know, I'm fairly comfortable. And being outside your comfort zone like this tonight, when it's going to get cold, you know, I'm going to grow as a person, and it's going to be awesome. The best. Oh yeah. Tea is coming along nicely. Oh, that's perfect. I'll just let that brew there. And I've got my cakes, my biscuits, my breads. Oh my goodness. Oh, just a bit of jam would be good with these. But on their own, they're almost like the same consistency as those sort of round potato cakes you get, potato breads. It tastes really sweet though. Not the hot side of the pot here, you see. Oh yeah, it's really good. So the brambles are really good for you. I can't remember why off the top of my head now. I know Naomi was drinking them when she was pregnant, bramble leaf tea, or was it raspberry leaf tea? Anyway, they're good for you. And then the pine needles, full of vitamin C, which is, as we know, really good, especially this time of year. A cup of this a day, keep the cold away. Oh, it's nice to have a warm drink as well. So good. It's getting dark now, so I think I've probably got about another hour and a half of light. Then it'll be bedtime. They're hot. Right, let's get this out of the fire. That's a really good bit of cooking slab. And now I can dry these feet.
There we go. So it's almost dark now. Sit and enjoy the fire for now. All about the pillow. The pillow is the most important thing. Still very mild here, by the way, which is good. I'm sure it'll get much cooler later on than that. Good night, folks, and I'll see you bright and early in the morning.
starting to rain a lot heavier now. He got bitten on the lip in the night by a beastie. But it was a good night, good primitive solo camp. Well, the fire obviously didn't last through the night, but there's the remnants of it. It was still pretty warm when I put my hand in there. I did a couple of bits, but as the rain's coming down now pretty heavily, I'm still pretty sheltered under here, but you can hear it. I've walked most of my furs out and stashed them. Just gonna get the rest of my kit out now and get out before it really pours down. It's about 6:30 in the morning. So that was a good first primitive solo video I've done. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe.